Kathy. We all remember it was an elite unit of Navy SEALs who led the raid on Osama bin Laden's compound in Pakistan. But the U.S. military also announced that one of their canines played a big role that night. They call them war dogs. Miguel Almaguer was able to access the facility in which those dogs become true fighters.
A training mission in the Nevada desert. A simulated high-stakes overnight raid. The 99th Ground Combat Squadron, heavily armed, but one of their best soldiers, doesn't carry a gun. These four-legged warriors pursue, track, and attack.
What they bring to the fight for us cannot be overstated. Their senses are what are literally saving people's lives.
Today, 2,700 war dogs are on active duty, leaping into battle, outfitted for war. Radio collars relay orders. Kevlar vests protect from gunfire. Goggles, they call doggles, shield their eyes. But it's their nose the military depends on.
Cover that.
Able to smell up to 10 times greater than humans, these German and Belgian shepherds are the best bomb detectors the military has. NBC News was given access during the intense training. Only the best of the best will be deployed.
During their nearly month-long training at this desert facility, the canines and their handlers will go through virtually every possible experience before they hit the battlefield.
The teams stay together for years, a bond that lasts a lifetime. War dogs are fiercely loyal to their handlers, as we found out.
As you can tell, you guys, you come any closer, you know, he might try to, you know, go after you and attack.
Tech Sergeant Julian Carlos spends more time with CART than with his family back home. 300 canines have died in the line of duty since the Vietnam War, but it's been said every military dog saves 150 lives.
They become my heroes. That's what I would classify them as.
War dogs, more than man's best friend, a special breed of soldier. Miguel Almaguer, NBC News, Las Vegas.